Hey, hey, hey! Welcome back to Food According to El Roca. So guys, in our recipe, we're gonna start by cutting 4 chicken breasts and then we're gonna mince them with a blender. Make sure it's minced all over, it's smooth and minced. And then we're gonna whip 1 cup of heavy cream. Then we're gonna whip it until it's nice and fluffy. Then we're gonna start mixing our ingredients, which is 4 chicken breasts minced, 1/2 cup of flour, 1 cup of whipped cream, 1 egg, 1 tablespoon of paprika, 1/4 cup of fresh coriander, 2 tablespoons of Worcester sauce, 1 tablespoon of green onion seasoning, and 1 tablespoon of crushed black pepper. So these are our ingredients. Just put them together inside the minced chicken, and then we're gonna mix them together with our hands. Wash your hands, guys. And then we're just gonna mix this together until everything is combined. So we seasoned it with some onion seasoning. So now we're going to use cling wrap. I doubled the cling wrap so that I can put the mixture on the cling wrap. As you can see, guys, the consistency, it's not too hard and it's not too runny. So you want to be able to work with it. So we're gonna put the mixture on the cling wrap and then we're gonna wrap it up to make sure that it's tight. You're gonna see how I'm gonna do it. So the main reason for this, we want to shape it so that we put it in the fridge. We're going to put it in the fridge for about 1 hour, but if you put it for a shorter time, you can put it in the freezer for like 15 minutes or so, and then it will be ready to be boiled. And you must make sure when you are wrapping it that it's tightly wrapped and there's no way where water can go inside. So you must wrap it tightly, and then we're gonna seal it at the on the sides. You're gonna see how I'm gonna do it. Put it in the fridge like that, and then we're gonna boil it. You're gonna see the process as we go along. So guys, this chicken roulade, you can slice it very thinly and serve it with bread if you like, but you can slice it as you can use thicker slices and serve it with a savory rice. You can check out the recipe that I have posted already with the savory rice. You can serve this with the savory rice and some vegetables, or you can have it with vegetables. It's very nice, it's delicious, and you can change the flavors of the chicken roulade. You can mix any flavor that you want. If you want it to be a little bit hot, you can add some chili flakes in there or some chili pepper, anything that you want to put in there to give it some flavor. So if you also like, you can leave it plain and just season it with some salt and black pepper and leave it as plain as it is. So it's up to you what you put in there in terms of flavoring. So as you can see, I'm sealing it on both sides and I'm gonna make sure it's tight. We don't want any water to go in there, but we want it when we boil it, it has to boil from the outside so that water mustn't seep into the roll. So after doing this, guys, we are going to put it in the fridge now, for like 1 hour. So as you can see, you can do any size that you want. As you can see, I've made 2 different sizes just to show you that you can make it in any size that you want. So it's now going to the fridge. So after it gets out of the fridge, now we're gonna put the rolls inside boiling water. I think it will take about 5 to 10 minutes, not too long. If it's thicker, like the bigger one, then you can leave it for a little bit longer, maybe 15 minutes. But if it's not, then 10 minutes, 5 to 10 minutes. Remember, chicken breast, it doesn't take that long to be cooked. So now after it gets out of the boiling water, now this is what it's gonna look like. And then now we're going to seal it on the sides. I want to brown it so that it mustn't be just white meat. So we're just gonna brown it on the sides. And then when it's brown, we're gonna now cut it and serve it. No, I won't burn. I'm used to touching hot things with my fingers. So guys, like, I'm used to that. So don't worry about my fingers there. So we're going to seal it and you'll see how brown it's gonna turn, and then we're gonna cut it. So you're gonna turn it until all sides are brown, and then you know it's sealed and nice and brown and ready to be served. So you take your sharp knife, as you can see guys, it's nice and brown, and now I'm gonna take a sharp knife and cut through it, and you can cut it in any shape that you want. And then serve it, make your plate look appetizing. So as you can see, you'll see on the plate that I served this with some vegetables, some mushroom and some spinach. You'll see on my plate, and some sugar snap peas. So guys, I hope you enjoyed the video, and guys, please try the recipe and tell me how you found it. And please comment and share and like the video, and please come back for more. I hope you enjoy this. Thank you for coming.